Hey y'all, Gizmo Hay here. Have you ever felt that your life is so bad that you want to run away to a distant country and change your personality and be a different person?
Yeah, みんな、Gizmo ね、ここ。私はとても頭のいい高校生で、夕食に生のお魚を食べて一人暮らしをしています。
Yeah, you're right. What a loser. Say, when a guy asked me if I've ever played a GTA 5, I showed them this. See ya.
Persona is one of the most popular games in the last decade. What happens if things that get popular? The company will milk it over and over and over until it finally dies, dang it! That's the secret to get GTA 6. You play as a student from Japan that has superpowers in another world. Yes, this game is just to teach those hikikomori how to get a life and manage their time. Once you play this game, I guarantee that you'll say, school has some great gameplay.
Oh yeah, this gameplay is on fire!
In Sony press conference, Atlus revealed in November of 2013 that a new game directed by Katsura Hoshino from the Persona series is being developed and will be released in winter of 2014 for the PlayStation 3. Later it was announced that Persona 5 will not only be for the PlayStation 3 but also will be in the new release PlayStation 4, but it was delayed to 2015. For reasons which are to improve the quality of the games on both platforms. Well, that stings, but hey, if their promises come through, then that's awesome! If not, then prepare to sharpen those pitchforks, fellas! 2015 came around, and we have no news on Persona 5 until the Tokyo Game Show. Atlus announced that the game would be delayed again to summer 2016. The director, Hoshino, apologized for the delay, reason being that it's necessary to deliver a high-quality game. Then finally, in April 2016, the countdown to the release of Persona 5 began and will be released in May 2016. Oh, whoops, I mean, a new information will come. The release date. Oh, that's gonna be in September 15. My bad, whoopsie!
Oh no! Anyway,
I wasn't there when it happened, but I could tell people were pretty excited after waiting for 3 years. Well, now we got Persona 5, finally.
Did I forget to mention it was releasing for Japan first? Ha! Well, worldwide release is in 2017. Oh, we got trolled there.
Whoa, 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 whoa! What was that?
Wait, what? Who are you?
You put a meme? You're not supposed to do that in a Scott Wars video.
Whoa, what am I supposed to do then?
Swearing. Yes! And you can't just talk about video games, you gotta be funny, especially if you're not funny. It's a good thing to yell a lot. People won't take you seriously if you aren't screaming.
I can't do this. Why should I swear? Swearing is funny? Well, I ain't funny. What is funny? When is it funny? How is it funny? Am I stupid?
Dude, that was the wackiest thing I've ever heard. It sounded like I am listening to one of those dumb family movies. The ones who's trying to be funny but not.
Well, it's not easy to make jokes, okay?
Then listen to me and follow Scott. He swears and that's what makes him so funny.
Huh. I guess you didn't know that you really should never swear. It's a sign of weak verbal skill.
No, you bitch!
Dude, I'm a guy.
Hey, I'm talking here. You decided to make a Scott the Waz video. Now you gotta act like Scott the Waz. Say something Scott would say.
Dude, I ain't doing this.
do it, and you might be popular. This is bull. Now that's it.
Now that I've gotten hit by a jack, I can finally talk about this dang game.
After what seemed like forever, Persona 5 was finally released.
I myself just so happened to be a fan since like a year ago, so the wait felt like nothing to me. So after finishing P4 last year, I decided to go get the PS3 version of Persona 5 from a sketchy website. So here's the copy that I got. Oh, okay. Alright, I've finished playing P5 the easiest way possible through a sin known as emulation. Yeah. Wait, who's that? Who's at the door?
Hello there. We are looking for a guy who's been pirating a bunch of games. Have you seen him? Huh, since when did the police care about emulating games? One of the improved features that makes Persona 5 stand out compared to the previous entries are the dungeons, also known as palaces. Palaces are a marvelous change in the Persona series. They all have very unique puzzles that really differentiate them from other palaces. I would say palaces get better the more you progress. I really like how they make all the palaces like some sort of heist. The first dungeon you go to is a castle, so you climb towers, sneak, steal, and lust. That's right, the bosses in this game is the most up villains you've ever seen. I guess that's why people hated the PE teacher. In my opinion, palaces are a breath of fresh air to the Persona's dungeon crawling. Although the Persona series have good stories, the dungeons are pretty lame, but they do have an awesome OST though. So this is Jazz. If you ask me which palaces is the worst among all the Persona 5 palaces, I would say Mementos. Mementos is the same old dungeon from the previous entries. It has nothing new. It's just a side quest. Well, it is pretty easy, but still. I was hoping maybe they would improve it or something. Well, they did give us an easy way to grind to level 99. Usually in the previous entries, the more you progress in the dungeons, the more the music changes and also the atmosphere changes too. But in Mementos, nothing changes except for the surroundings. Mementos gets very, very repetitive, like so quickly. Why, dang it, Atlas, you really gotta make some video game that has a tower dungeon. Almost all their games have tower dungeons. This is definitely an Atlas moment, certified. The puzzles in palaces is where the magic happens. In Mementos, we got nothing, absolutely nothing. All we got is just trains and this much of boredom.
Hey guys, my ass itches.
Oh my god!
Persona 5's gameplay is very unique. It's a turn-based game where you take your time and think up a very, and I mean very, simple strategy. You guys thought I was serious? I swear, this is literally the same gameplay as any other Persona game, ever since Persona 3. Well, you could say it was ever since the first Persona game, but those have grits. And seriously, who plays games with grits now? Don't answer that. What you see is what came from the previous entries or other Atlas projects. There are a few new random special attacks that you can't trigger by yourself, but you don't really need them because most of the gameplay is just you trying to hit for weakness and finish them off with an all-out attack. Well, the game looks so stylish with all the blood splats that's on the screen and epilepsy. Most of the art style and engine they use in Catherine is the same one that they use in Persona 5. Catherine was pretty much the building blocks for the foundation of this game. This art style and animation is what people criticize the game for. All the cool animation when you attack, the cool guns from the original Persona game, follow-up attacks that have been in every Persona game since Persona 3, and of course more epilepsy. Some of these attacks don't even work on the final bosses, so some of them are completely useless, if I remember correctly, like all-out attack. Now, if you guys are in trouble, just try and hit for critical hits from a physical attack, because they consume HP, which is easier to get back unless they counter them. So yeah, that's a small tip from me. Basically, what I'm trying to say is try and use physical attacks. Usually physical attacks rarely get blocked, so you should probably use charge, Tarukaja, and then debilitate the enemy, and as a result will deal a massive amount of damage. These attack mechanics are just from the previous games or from other games that Persona is based on, Pokemon. No, you dummy. Shin Megami Tensei. Remember when they put Shin Megami Tensei on top of the Persona logo? I guess they don't want people to know that Shin Megami Tensei gave birth to Waifu Wars. Well, this is the reason why Persona games are so long nowadays. You have to spend your time eating Big Macs to gain knowledge. Wait, what? This feature was first introduced back in Persona 3. However, you don't get to hang out with your teammates. You mostly hang out with mostly the girls of your teammate. And that's the start of Dating Simulator. In Persona, there's a Second Awakening, which is basically an evolution to your Persona. The way you can do it is to max out your companion's relationship. But in Persona 3, the way you evolve their Persona is by going through the story. And Persona 5 follows Persona 4's evolution by having you to max their confidant level to get their second awakening. I feel like Persona 3 did the social links in the right way. They are not something that people might completely finish, so they let the story progress. And that's where you see their character development. But Persona 5 has to follow Persona 4's way of doing social links. The character doesn't feel like they have changed through the story and leaving some of the characters no time in the limelight. One thing to take note of is that they have improved the confidant to not just give you bonus XP when fusing, but bonus ability depending on the person. Like most of the Phantom Thieves gives you special help during battles, such as follow up, protect, and a few special abilities of their own. Other confidants give you XP share, using guns, gun modeling. We really are a crime boss, and literally nothing. What kind of kid goes to a bar? Let me just say the confidant social links have been improved. But the problem is, they keep recycling stories from the previous entries. Some of the characters are almost exactly alike one another. I get it, you can't keep making new stories, but at least try and make them a bit shorter. Or maybe just make them a little bit different somehow. I'm not really a game designer, so maybe I'm not fit to suggest these things.
Wait, where's all the words that I told you to use?
Come on, man. Not all Scott jokes are funny.
No! You wanted to make a Scott the Waz video.
Well, yeah.
Then you gotta do what the Scott the Waz do. If you wanna be a Scott, you gotta be a Waz.
What does that mean? What the f*** does that mean?
Now you're a Waz.
So now that my head has been slapped by a jack again, we can continue to talk about the juicy story. The story starts with you being a thief on a mission that you successfully failed at, and you got to escape, but you failed to escape from the police. So you've been brought to prison, like where most delinquents go to. I like the logic behind how the stories are told. By a beat up Joker who's been injected with drugs. Man, he's really high. You are supposed to remember your journey with your friends, and if you fail to remember, then the game will call you a psycho, and in the end, you live in a prison. Forever. Statistics shows that 99% of people who spreads misinformation ends up like this. That's why we're gonna truthfully talk about the spoilers. The beginning of the game has some good pacing going on. They let you learn how to manage your schedule and combat system very early, unlike some games that I know of. Well, most of the villains are just bastards, and because of these villains, they ruin your life. This is exactly what I would expect people to do in Judgment Day. That's why the Phantom Thieves were created, so they can help those who can't help themselves. And to show that, the villains are very compelling. They make the most out of the villains' backstories, but I would say they should have made the final boss a secret until the end. They shouldn't have shown his face in a flashback. If they let us guess, then we could have gotten more hype in the final battle. I'd say each month is pretty solid. They always give you new dungeons around the beginning of the month. Usually in that month, we get some progression in the story with some characters opening up to you. People say that there are a few main characters that didn't get enough time to flesh out their characters. For me, the reason why I find the story so good is because the story gives you the feeling of wanting to know what happens next. Even in The Confidant alone, they make you curious about their problems. Even some random side characters will make you interested in them. In the middle of every Confidant, always shows you the struggles that the Confidant needs to overcome and final resolution where you help them overcome their problems. Oh boy, even the story is like this. Confidant's story alone is enough to make you understand everything to know about that character. But like I said before, they don't feel like they changed because they can't make everyone say new one-liners just because you only finish one Confidant and nothing else. You must be a hikikomori to only do that many Confidants. If you didn't care about Confidants, no part of the story will change. You could practically save up 50 hours of the game. That's 50 hours gone when you could spend it on crying about your girlfriend leaving you. The ending could have been shorter and straight to the point. That's why I think the best Confidants are the ones that complete themselves. What do I mean by that? It's the Confidant that only completes through the story. There are only 4 characters who do this, and I think they are the only Confidants that can be taken seriously. For example, Morgana at first shows you what his motives are, which is to help the team. He tells you he wants to be a human. He wants to remember what being a human is like. But then he starts to realize, even if he's not a human that he always dreamed of, he still felt that he has a reason to stay and guide the team. Igor is also another example that I like to talk about. When the trailer revealed that Igor had a different voice, I imagine that he got replaced by a different voice actor because to keep it consistent with the Japanese, since the Japanese voice actor apparently passed away a few years before the game came out. So it made me think, this will be the voice of Igor from here on out. I'm pretty sure they decided to do this just to make Igor feel a bit more creepy because look at this guy. But no way they had a plan for the voice change. Hoo boy! Then we get Akechi. People think he's not really that great, but they're so wrong. They don't even know what they're talking about. He has everything that Joker didn't have, and he was supposed to be the opposite of Joker, who possesses the same ability as him. But all he used it for is for himself. He didn't have any family or friends to support him. All he thinks about is doing everything by himself. That's why he was curious about Joker. When Joker finally beat Akechi, he finally realized that working together will make the dream work. God, that's so cringy! Why did I decide to do this? You know, in the end of Persona 5, the villains have taught me a valuable lesson. Don't let anything or anyone, big or small, twist your heart.
Desires are supposed to be controlled, not to be satisfied. That's what I find P5 so fascinating. If you help a dog from dying of thirst, you would be sent to heaven. If you let a cat die of thirst, you will be sent to hell. Never underestimate your actions. Well, that's all I want to talk about. The ending is very wholesome. Most of the Persona series have a very good ending. Most of them. After the end of the dungeon, you still need to make sure that Shido has proof of being guilty. So you're the only one that will be the proof of his crime. In the end, you end up in jail for committing crimes. But then, when all seems lost, your confidants all comes together to aid you. So even if you have no superpowers, it doesn't stop your friends to try and make a difference. That's right, you can definitely get out of any situation as long as you have friends. If only I had one. Igor, you are an awesome traitor. And do not get me started on the Velvet Room attendant. She's...
FBI!
Wait, what? Why is the FBI here? I don't live in America.
Well, you wanted to be like Scott the Waz, so now you're in Ohio.
What the Ohio? Wait, what happened to my face?
You're becoming like Scott the Waz. Now you're Scott the Waz!
No, this can't be! Give me an What? How come I can't grab you? God, no!
I'm not really here. I'm here because you wanted to be Scott. This is exactly what you wanted, isn't it?
No, it ain't!
Are you sure? You wanted to gain more fame by trendjacking from Scott.
Damn, you're right about that one. What the I sound just like him! I look like him as well! What the is happening?
We can hear you in there, now open up.
Wait a minute, this whole thing happened because I wanted to be Scott the Waz.
What nonsense are you saying?
Well, I don't want to be Scott the Waz anymore.
Wait, no, I thought you wanted to have fame like Scott the Waz.
Not anymore, I want to be myself. I don't need to act like some sort of big YouTuber just to be famous. I want to be famous by doing things my own way.
You son of a
No swearing allowed in my videos.
What? I can't swear? Are you kidding me?
I open up!
No way. I'm not in Ohio. And I'm not Scott the Waz! Oh yeah, we're talking about in Persona 5. Okay, so... I know this is a Persona 5 review, but... just play Persona 5 Royal. I think that one, it has a few improvements. Although, the original can stand on its own. But I think the remake is a bit better. Pretty good game, but I highly recommend you play this game with a guide because it's enough to play it just once, you know. If you have completed it once, just end it right there. Enough banging chicks, guys. You need to wake up, get up, get up there! Hey, if you're worried about my face, don't worry. This here, it's not blood, okay? It's just tomato sauce.